morning, City Kids. It's another Sunday and I am super excited to be studying God's Word with you today. I hope you're all doing well. I'm sure some of you have resumed school. I hope school is going well and you're remembering to stay safe at all times. You're wearing your nose masks, you're praying, and then you're also helping mommy and daddy around the house, and you're studying your books as well. I'm sure you're good children and you're doing all of that. So before we start our lesson today, we're going to pray as we always do. And then after our prayers, we're going to play a very interesting game. And then after that, we're going to watch our video for today and also learn God's word. So close your eyes with me and let's pray. In Jesus' name, Father, we say thank you for yet another Sunday. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for an opportunity to be gathered before you. We pray and ask, Lord, that even as we study your word, that you grant us wisdom, you grant us knowledge, and you grant us understanding. And at the end of our Bible story today, you teach us your word, and that we'll go about our daily lives practicing everything that we've been taught in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so the title of our game today is Move Forward and Freeze. Does that sound interesting? Move forward and freeze. So now I want you to do something. I'm going to stand right here, and wherever you are, I would like for you to move back. But make sure you can hear me. Move as far away from me as you can. Make sure there is nothing around you that can hurt you, and make sure you're very careful. So I'm going to close my eyes and I'm going to count. So when my eyes are closed, I want you to come towards me. But when I open my eyes and I stop counting, I want you to freeze in whatever position you're at. Do you understand? Okay, so I'm going to take that again. I'm going to stand here and you're going to move as far as you can away from me. But make sure you can hear me. So when I close my eyes, I'm going to count. When I'm counting, I want you to move towards me. But when I stop counting, you're going to freeze in whatever position you are at. So let's try. So I'm sure you're all standing away from me. So right now I'm going to close my eyes and count. One. I hope you're moving towards me now. Two. Take another step. Three. And freeze. So stand still. Are you sure you're standing still? So we're going to try it again. I'll need you to move again away from your screen, away from me, and I'll count and you move forward. This time I'm going to try to be a little bit faster, so make sure you come towards me faster than the first time. But please, please make sure you're careful so you don't fall down and you don't hurt yourself, okay? So let's do it again. One, two, freeze. Ah, interesting. So try that one more time. So move away from your screen, move away. And when I count, I want you to walk towards me again. So let's do that again. One, two, three, four, and freeze. See, playing the game, you can see that it is very hard for us to stand still as a statue. Do you know what a statue is? So statues are like, they are artworks basically, that they just mold and they're just stagnant in one place. They can't move, they can't talk, they can't do anything. And you notice that when you had to stand still, it was a little uncomfortable for you, right? It's also very hard for some of us to believe in the things that we already know. So in today's Bible story, we're going to be learning how Peter had to talk to Christians, people who follow Jesus Christ, to continue to trust Jesus even in very hard times. So we're going to watch our video and then we'll come back and have our own discussion.
Hey everybody, my name is Megan.
And my name is Jesse.
Jesse, you sound sad.
I am sad, Megan.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want to tell us about it?
Yeah, I guess so. Sam and Andre made fun of me and called me a baby.
Oh, I'm so sorry that happened, Jesse. Being called names hurts.
We were having fun riding our bikes, but then Sam and Andre turned out of our neighborhood. My mom said I'm not allowed to ride my bike out of our neighborhood. When I wouldn't go, they laughed and called me a baby.
Oh.
Then they went off and left me.
Oh, Jesse, I'm really sorry that happened. But I'm really proud of you for doing the right thing. You obeyed your mom, even when it was hard.
Thanks, Megan.
In today's Bible story, people were being mean and unfair to Jesus' followers. Jesus' disciple Peter wrote a letter to encourage them. Listen to the story.
Jesus' followers did not have an easy life after Jesus went back to heaven. Some people did not like that they shared the good news about Jesus. Those people were mean or unfair to Jesus' followers.
Many people who trusted in Jesus had to move away from their homes to be safe. Peter was one of Jesus' disciples. Now, he was a leader in the church. He wrote a letter to help Jesus' followers in other cities. Peter wanted to tell these believers to keep following Jesus, even when it was hard.
Peter said, "Praise God, he has given us new life. We have hope for the future because of Jesus. He died, but now he is alive." Peter said that people in God's family have blessings in heaven. These blessings cannot be taken away. We are joyful as we remember this promise, even though life is not always easy. When hard times happen, we can trust God. This honors him.
Peter also wrote, "Be holy like Jesus." Peter reminded Jesus' followers that before they knew and loved Jesus, they lived however they wanted. Jesus gave his life to save them so they could have a better life. Peter said, "This world is not your home forever. Do not live like people who like to do wrong things. Instead, do what is good. Serve God. Obey those who God has put in charge. Show love and respect to everyone. Others will see the good things you do and they will praise God. Jesus showed us how to live. He was punished for our sins so that we can live to do what is right."
The Bible says Christians will face hard times for following Jesus. Peter wrote a letter to help Jesus' followers live with hope and joy. Through hard times, God makes us more like Jesus.
Welcome back, friends. So you see, from our Bible story today, we can tell that it was all about Peter trying to encourage Christians, Peter trying to encourage the followers of Christ. Now, after Jesus Christ went into heaven, Jesus' disciples didn't have an easy time at all preaching the word of God. People around them didn't make it easy for them at all. And that was because they didn't like the fact that Jesus' disciples went about talking about Jesus, preaching the good news. Remember, before Jesus went to heaven, he told his disciples that he was going to send them the Holy Spirit to empower them so that they could be able to preach God's words, they'll be able to heal the sick, they'll be able to do all the things that Jesus Christ wanted them to do. So those were the things they were doing after Jesus Christ left them and went into heaven. But other people around them who did not believe in Jesus didn't like what they were doing. And that was why they were mean to them. They were unfair to them. They were just being very terrible to them. And you know what? Some of Jesus' disciples had to leave their homes. They had to go somewhere else just so they could be saved, just so that they would stop receiving all of this unfair treatment, and then they would be able to preach the word of God. Peter was one of Jesus' disciples, right? And he wasn't happy about what was going on, so he decided to write a letter to the followers of Jesus Christ. Peter was also a leader in the church, so he wasn't happy at all that Jesus' disciples were being treated unfairly. So he wrote a letter to them, and in the letter he wanted them to be joyful. He wanted them to praise God regardless of all that they were going through. He knew that they were having a hard time, but then even in the difficult time that they were having, he wanted them to be happy and continue doing God's work, continue to trust in God. So in his letter, do you know what he said to the disciples of Jesus? He said that they should be joyful, that even though they are going through hard times, that they should learn to trust in him, and that this world is not their home and they are not going to be on earth forever, that they will go to heaven, they will be in heaven where all the blessings that God has stored for them cannot be taken away from them. So regardless of all that they were going through, he wanted them to have hope. And you know why? Because Jesus Christ died and he resurrected, meaning that he died to save us. He gave us new life, and that also meant that for us, even though in the past we could live and do whatever we wanted, Because Jesus Christ died for us, we are now new beings and we now live in Christ. That was what he wanted the people to know. He wanted them to be happy at all times, to have hope, and most importantly, have joy, to obey their leaders, to do all that Jesus Christ had instructed them to do, which includes preaching the gospel to people, going around telling people about God, everything that they knew about Jesus, all that they were taught about Jesus, they were supposed to teach other people so that when they're doing good, it would make other people notice and say, oh, these people do good things, that's very good. Instead of doing the bad things that we do, instead of living bad and evil lives, maybe we too should join Jesus' disciples and do the good things that they do. And that was all that Jesus really wanted them to do. So from today's lesson, we have learned that as Christians, we're going to go through very hard times. People around us are not always going to welcome us. They are not always going to like the fact that we preach the good news. They will not like the fact that we talk about God all the time. But regardless of all of that, you must learn to trust in God. You should learn to be happy. Why? Because you have Jesus, and because Jesus is going to be with us all through the way. He's never going to forget us. He's never going to abandon us. And when we get to heaven, we're going to all live happy lives, and all the blessings that God has for us, we're going to enjoy all of it. So that is what we've learned from today's story. Okay, friends, so now that we've learned our Bible story for today, we're going to be taking our memory verse, which is from Romans chapter 12, verse 5. It says, "We who are many are one body in Christ." Do you all remember the song? I know we've been singing and reciting that from the beginning of the month, and we've come to the end of the month, which means that today is going to be the last day we're taking our memory verse. So I want you all to sing along, dance, be happy, and remember you must recite your memory verse every day of the week, from Sunday to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, up until next week Sunday, where you learn another memory verse. So let's take our memory verse, Romans 12 verse 5.
Romans 12:5, we are one.
So now that we've learned our memory verse, we're going to pray and then we're going to close. So let's close our eyes and pray in Jesus' name. Father, we say thank you for your word. Thank you for teaching us that even as Christians, we're going to go through hard times. But even in those hard times, you're always going to be with us. We pray, O Lord God Almighty, that you help us, O Lord Jesus, to continue to trust in you, even when the situations around us are not pleasing. That, Lord, we trust you, would continue to rejoice in you, and even as we hope for your coming again. Thank you, Father, because we know you have heard and you will do even more than we have asked of you in Jesus' name. Amen. So do not forget, from our Bible story today, we have learned that as Christians, we are going to go through hard times. But even in those hard times, we should all learn to trust in God and to obey God regardless, because this world is not our home and we will not be here for long. And as believers, as children of God, as Christians, all the blessings that God has for us cannot be taken away from us. So in hard times, always remember to trust God. I hope to see you again soon. Bye.